morning, we're going to continue with our consecration to St. Joseph. Day number 14. Zealous defender of Christ, pray for us. He, St. Joseph, protects those who revere him and accompanies them on their journey through this life, just as he protected and accompanied Jesus when he was growing up, by St. Jose Maria Escriva. From the moment the angel revealed to St. Joseph that he was to be the father of the Messiah, to when he took his final breath in the arms of Jesus and Mary, St. Joseph zealously defended Jesus. St. Joseph always defended his son from any threat against him. St. Joseph was a dutiful watchman, guarding, defending, and sacrificing everything for Jesus and his safety. St. Joseph offered the same protection for his wife too. He protected his son and his wife as a loving father and faithful husband. In some translations of the Litany of St. Joseph, the title Zealous Defender of Christ is given as Diligent Defender of Christ or Watchful Defender of Christ. Both are acceptable translations and have similar meanings. Namely, St. Joseph defended Jesus. As a child of St. Joseph, you can have great confidence knowing that your spiritual father also desires to zealously defend you. St. Joseph zealously defends you. The eternal mission of St. Joseph is not finished. A father's work is never finished until his children are safely home. In heaven, St. Joseph no longer needs to watch over and protect Jesus. You, however, are not yet in heaven. You need the protection of St. Joseph. Your spiritual father knows what is harmful to your soul, and he wants to watch over you and help you arrive safely home. St. Joseph will never abandon you. Your role is to entrust yourself to his diligent care and never look back. Our destiny is in the hands of Joseph. Joseph, the guardian of his Lord and the spouse of his Queen, Joseph, the foster father of Jesus and the head of the Holy Family, has in kindness deigned to accept us as his children and permits us to call him Father. By blessed woman Joseph Gemini, you have nothing to fear with St. Joseph at your side. What is there to be afraid of with such a zealous defender as your father who loves you? St. Joseph put the maker of the universe in his hands. St. Joseph met the creator of the heavens. In his role as earthly father to Jesus, St. Joseph lovingly commanded the Son of God. Heaven and earth obeyed him. All hell trembles before him. Joseph's name will be the name of protection all during our lives. As Christians, we ought to honor St. Joseph, to thank him for his protection, to pray to him with fervor and confidence, to strive to reproduce in our conduct the virtues he practiced with so much perfection. By Venerable Nelson Baker. St. Joseph will increase your zeal for Christ. As your father and model, St. Joseph will teach you how to defend Christ zealously. If you are a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ, you are going to be criticized, hated, ridiculed, and mocked by the world, oftentimes by your own family and friends. Your suffering will be great, but your witness to truth, your witness to Jesus, will be greater. St. Joseph will help you be a zealous witness to the truth of Jesus Christ. Your defense of Christ must be great. You should always strive to defend the person and name of Jesus Christ against all blasphemy, insult, and sacrilege. You must defend the church as well as her teachings and sacraments from all attacks heresies, false sins. To defend the church is to defend Christ. You must resemble your spiritual father, always willing to sacrifice yourself for love of truth. St. Joseph, you too can bring many souls to Jesus. How happy and blessed are they whom you, St. Joseph, love and whom you take under your protection. Litany of St. Joseph. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Noble offspring of David,
pray for us.
Light of patriarchs,
pray for us.
Spouse of the Mother of God,
pray for us.
Chaste guardian of the Virgin,
pray for us.
Foster father of the Son of God,
pray for us.
Celestial defender of Christ, head of the Holy Family,
pray for us.
Joseph most just,
pray for us.
Joseph most chaste,
pray for us.
Joseph most prudent,
pray for us.
Joseph most courageous,
pray for us.
Joseph most obedient,
pray for us.
Joseph most faithful,
pray for us.
Mirror of patience,
pray for us.
Lover of poverty,
pray for us.
Model of workmen,
pray for us.
Glory of domestic life,
pray for us.
Guardian of virgins,
pray for us.
Pillar of families,
pray for us.
Comfort of the afflicted,
pray for us.
Hope of the sick,
pray for us.
Patron of the dying,
pray for us.
Terror of demons,
pray for us.
Protector of the Holy Church,
pray for us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
mercy, hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
He has made him Lord of his household
and Prince of all his possessions.
Let us pray. O God, when your loving providence chose Blessed Joseph to be the spouse of your most holy mother, grant us the favor of having him for our intercessor in heaven, whom on earth we venerate as our protector. You, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Welcome to St. Bernadette Missionary Disciples family. Today is the second Sunday of Lent. Please, year 5, wave and hi to your neighbor. We ask that you please wear your mask and maintain social distancing at all times, as well as silencing your phone and preparing your heart to celebrate the sacred liturgy. Today's reading, God's call, is personal and at the same time very demanding. It is an invitation to enter into His holiness with an attitude of faith and total trust in God, like Noah and Abraham. We encounter a God who speaks to us, and we are called upon to listen to Him and respond to Him. Now, as we enter the second week of Lent, our task is to continue to examine our hearts and change ourselves in order to be worthy of His glorious Paschal mystery. Our celebrant today is Father John Peter, assisted by Deacon Joe, Deacon Ben. Please rise. We will sing our gathering song.
Thank you. In order for us to offer this Mass in a worthy manner, let's recall to our mind our sins and ask the Lord for grace and mercy.
Lord Jesus, keep calm the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, keep calm sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray.
O God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. In this Mass, we continue to pray for the end of this pandemic and healing, health, and well-being of all people, especially for St. Bernadette's family and for all the faithful departed, especially for Narvin Garcia.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, Abraham. Here I am, he replied. Then God said, take your son Isaac, your only one whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, Abraham, Abraham. Here I am, he answered. Do not lay your hand on the boy, said the messenger. Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son. As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as a holocaust in place of his son. Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did in withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies, and in your descendants all the nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my command. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Oh, Lord.
courts of the house of heaven, in your midst, O Jerusalem, I will walk before the Lord, in the land of the living.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? Christ Jesus it is who died, or rather was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Dazzling white, such as no fool on earth could reach them. And Elijah appeared to them, along with Moses. They were conversing with Jesus. And Peter said to Jesus in reply, Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. He hardly knew what to say, for they were so terrified. And a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. This is my beloved son. Listen to him. Suddenly, looking around, he no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. This is the gospel of the Lord. Today is the beginning of the second week of Lent. We hear in today's first reading Abraham's obedience to God. In the Gospel, we hear the revelation of Jesus as the Son of God. For today, I want to maybe focus in on what I call the four T's. Four T's are test, trust, transfiguration, and transformation. The first reading, you hear that God asked Abraham to give back to him something that he really loved a lot, and that was his son Isaac, to return Isaac to God as an offering. Now, as we know the story, that Abraham and Sarah were not able to have children, but God had promised to both of them that Sarah would bear a son years, after she could even have children. So God fulfilled his promise. In the tradition and in the custom of the Jews back in those days, the afterlife was not really something they really had anything that they knew about. What they knew that was important to them was that their personal existence only can continue if there was children. Something along along the same lines as what we have today, where, you know, your last name, you know, it's continued, you know, if you have children, especially sons, that would continue on with your last name down into the future. And if one couple did not have children in those days, then of course their name would not be continued beyond the grave. So Abraham would not have had his name be known in the future. He did not have a son. And the other thing is, for a couple not to have children was also considered a curse. So, as I said, God had promised both of them a son, Isaac. And today, God requests that Isaac be returned to him. I'm sure that was really hard for Abraham, because that was something he was longing for and he was hoping for, and now God asked him to return Isaac back to him. And in spite of how Abraham may have felt, he was obedient to God, and he did as what God requested, because he had faith in God and he trusted God. So there's your first T, trust. And because of the fact that he was willing to do that, he glorified God. God, in turn, not asked for Isaac. He saved, he spared him, in other words. So, in addition to that, because he was glorified by Abraham and listening to him, he gave him many more numerous things, as we hear in the scripture. We hear that he had many more descendants, more numerous than the stars in the sky and the sand by the seashore. But what we learn from Abraham is that he was tested, and that's the second T. He was put to the test. And if you want to say, Abraham passed the test, and he was rewarded, and that was true. But Abraham was attentive, paid attention, and listened to what God asked, and he listened to God's commandment. And so, he was generous in that sense that he gave back to God what he had received. And for us to have something like that maybe asked of us, like Abraham, I think that'll be a pretty hard thing to do. The question is, will we pass the test? Well, the answer to that is pretty simple. You know, we listen to God and we listen to what he wants us to do, and we do as he asks, and of course, you know, we pass the test. In life, we're often put in under the gun, and we are often put into test mode just because of things that happened, things that happened currently, in the past, or in the future. You know, we're constantly being tested. And in my own life, I can't say that I endure the same test as Abraham, but in some sense, I have. As I may have heard, told you in my previous homilies, I have 7 children, but in actuality, I have 8. I had an older daughter that passed away at the age of 7. And at the time, she wasn't sick, there wasn't anything wrong, and something happened, and she pretty much came and passed away all in a day's time. And it really was a tough time, a tough situation for myself, going through all that. On top of that, other things happened afterwards as well. So, in order for me to deal with everything, I placed my faith and my trust in God. I didn't understand why it happened, nor do I still know to this day what happened. But I trust and I have faith in God that there was a purpose and a reason for that. And maybe one day when I'm face to face with God, God will tell me why that happened. But as I said, my faith and my trust in God has led me to find peace in what happened, and peace in my journey of faith. As a matter of fact, you know, I want to say, I have a conversion of faith. It's led me to who I am today and what I am today. Our second reading is much more encouraging, and it's also hopeful. Paul tells us and assures us of three things. No objections, there's no condemnation, and then there's no separation. This is because God gave us His only begotten Son for us. He did this willingly for our sake, as He says in John 3:16. For so God loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. God would do anything to save us, including giving up His Son. And the Son is who is going to journey with us on our faith journey and in life. Today's gospel is about the scene of the transfiguration of Jesus. It's the third T, transfiguration. He manifests His glory to His three disciples there. The transfiguration reflects His divinity, that He is the Son of God. Transfiguration is also a glimpse of God's gift to us, giving up His Son to us, so that we can be saved and also see the glory of God. Today, Jesus reveals His future glory to us, but in order to complete His glory, He had to suffer. He also had to be crucified. And this is the road that all of us must take to suffer and to be crucified. As Christians and as Catholics, we endure suffering as it is, but in terms of crucifixion, we will not endure the same crucifixion as Jesus would. But the crucifixion that we may endure could be things that others might look at us, ridicule us, make fun of us, ostracize us because of our faith and because of our belief. Those are the crucifixion things that we have to deal with. The gospel today is about hope as well, just as Paul's letter indicates. The glory that is ours is through Jesus. It's also, God tells us that this is my begotten Son, and all we have to do is do one thing, and that is to listen to Him. We would you listen to Him, that our lives and our ways will be transformed. And that's the fourth T. And it's about living according to the Word of God, and also doing the will of God and being obedient to His will. It's also paying attention to what our church teaches us today, what the Word teaches us every day. Jesus speaks to us through those whom He brings to us, people that are marginalized, the poor, the sick, the elderly, the aborted, communities in distress, those that are going through difficulty, the wounded, the deserted, and all others that need our help. Our parish here is a very generous parish. We have many ministries to help those that are in need. And I'm very thankful that we are able to do that. So is the diocese and other parishes as well. So we as a church have done a lot. And all the generosity that we show to others, we get many times back in generosity as well for the effects and the generosity that those people that we minister to give back to us. So today in prayer, let us seek to do the will of God in all things. And maybe we can see the transfiguration of God in of Jesus in us as we transform into to be better people, to have complete trust and belief in God. This transformation is not only a temporary one, but one that should be one that's permanent, where it changes us forever and we are forever different people. So let us give all to the Lord and receive from Him whatever He gives to us, or whomever that He gives back to us. We ask this in Jesus Christ, our Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with us forever and ever. Amen. In the Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. At this moment, Sister Catherine has a few things that she wants to talk to you about.
Those who do not know me, my name is Sister Catherine, and I have the blessing of serving the families, children, youth here at St. Bernadette as the Director of Religious Education. Last year, a great opportunity was before us, and to tell you the truth,
I was a bit scared because it was something completely new, requiring a lot of work and creativity. Due to the pandemic, our classrooms were closed and our catechists could no longer teach the faith in person. One thing was clear, we needed to continue evangelizing, forming, and catechizing our children and youth. We did not have the resources nor the curriculum to make our program an online experience. However, this did not stop us. On the contrary, with the encouragement and leadership of our pastor, Father John Peter, and of our administrator, Gabe, and all the staff, we looked at every approved curriculum, searching for the best one for us, St. Bernadette. 1 year later, in September 2020, we became the first parish in our deanery to offer remote learning. Last year, we had about 120 families enrolled in our program. This year, we have 70. It has been a decrease, but we hope to reach all families. Taking into consideration their situations, we provide families with two curriculum options. Option number one is remote learning, where families have access to ebooks, sessions, videos, activities, and prayers. Option number two, home base. Here, families teach at home and parents are the main catechists. We also provide for them lessons, activities, and prayers. With the direct membership, mentorship, and guidance of Deacon's wife, Tracy Jo. This past week, we just launched our Lenten Family Resource page. Helping families live this Lent in a more prayerful way by offering activities, prayers, and videos. So as you can see, we have a strong online curriculum, making us true missionary disciples that, thanks to your generosity and the generosity of our catechists, their sacrifice, commitment, has helped us bring this to life. We are proud of our catechists. Their love and patience is a sign of God's presence in our midst. There is still more to be done. Formation for the whole family with materials, guides, and resources that can transform their homes into living domestic church. Formation for catechists, enrichment courses, retreats, webinars. These are just a few of many things that we are looking forward to providing. I'm here to ask for your support, your generosity, and most of all, your prayers. We can continue to grow and expand. Fill out your VIP form, please, and thank you. God bless.
Thank you. Thank you, Sister Catherine and Deacon Ben, for the beautiful homily and the sharing. I just, you know, deeply love our community, but this time I really wanted to encourage all the families to step up and support the mission ministry appeal, because it's helped out a lot. We just found out that we have 1,400, you know, families, you know, every year it increases. But what is one thing that has been very standard is only 17-20% participation of the VMA of the 1,400. So it comes like 300-350 families only participate, versus we serve all the families. And some of us might be thinking, I'm single, I don't have any children, I am just elderly, I don't have anybody. No, each one of us are responsible to pass on this faith. So VMA is for all the families of our community. So I encourage you this year, our goal is to bring more families on board supporting the ministries that we do here in Bernadette. If you have received your envelope, you're welcome to, you know, mail it, drop it off at the office. If you receive today, please drop it off at the back of the church. There is a box over there. but without your support, we may not be able to do everything. I'm so grateful to Sister Catherine for being a fearless leader in matters of religious education and passing on this formation to families, and we have a lot to do, as she said. So please help us, and now we stand for the creed. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things, visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, God and the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with all Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, he was the incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified and upon his body. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who in the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, to the life of the world to come. Let us pray to our loving God for our needs and for the needs of our community and the world.
For the church, may she be a light in the midst of darkness to the nations of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all leaders, ecclesial and civil, that they will govern in truth and humility, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our St. Bernadette's community, that we may bear witness to the ever-present love of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For an increase in vocations to the ordained and consecrated life for the greater honor and glory of God and service of God's people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the sick, the homeless, and the oppressed, may they find comfort in Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The health and safety of Pope Francis during his journey to Iraq, that his visit might promote peace, reconciliation, and dialogue, and that it will be a support to the struggling Christian community there, we pray to the Lord. For the end of the COVID-19 pandemic, the sick and suffering from this virus, may the Lord heal and protect them, we pray to the Lord. For the dearly departed, especially for Norwin Garcia, whom this Mass is offered, may the good Lord grant them mercy, forgiveness, and full blessings in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the intentions of our St. Bernadette's community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayers. Holy God, we bless and thank you for listening to our prayers. Grant to us according to divine will. Bless all of us who gather here in the house of God and all those who are joining through live stream at home. You know the needs of all of us. May the God of mercy and love provide to us according to divine will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness, we come to sleep this bread, the offering, gift of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine. We offer you fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become for us the spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Praise sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord sacrifice and for the grace of God you receive, our good and our all.
May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told his disciples of his coming death, on the holy mountain he manifested them his glory, to show even by the testimony of the law and the prophets that the passion leads to the glory of his resurrection. And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, benes in celi et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving you thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, mine and our Bishop, and all the clergy. Blessed up for the intentions of all your children who gather here in spirit and truth to love and honor and serve and worship you. Remember your servant, Norbert Garcia, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in resurrection. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed St. Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, St. Bernadette, our patron, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Stand at the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching. Together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us now into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who will live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer
one
another a sign of peace.
Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
My soul shall be in the body of Christ, keep us safe for eternal.
Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen.
Let us pray.
As we receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us while still on earth to be partakers, even now, of the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's bow our heads for blessing. Bless your faithful, we pray, O Lord, with a blessing that endures forever, and keep them faithful to the gospel of your only begotten Son, so that they may always desire and at last attain that glory whose beauty you showed in his own body, to the amazement of his apostles. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Eucharistic celebration has ended. Go forth, glorify the Lord with your life.
Thanks be to God. Just a couple of reminders about weekly activities, especially on Friday. We have the Power of Prayer talk, 3 p.m. with the Eucharistic Adoration and Praying Rosary at Divine Mercy Chaplet through live stream as well as Zoom. And the link is available in the website. Also, every Friday, because of Lent, we have Stations of the Cross at 5:30 p.m. Every Friday. You're welcome to join us, and as you can see, we are safely, securely open the church, and we are all in, and there's more people coming, and so, because a lot of people are receiving vaccination, and more, people are strong now, and most importantly, we are having a mask, we're cleaning our hands and keeping our safe, and the flu is kind of off guard, right? So, see, we have things work, so we got to keep working on the good stuff. So may God bless you all. Have a blessed week.
Thank you for having me.